If you know someone, if it's you, or there's a young person in your life, an old person in your life, a middle-aged person in your life that is unhappy with their job, I pray that you have the courage to do something about it, because it's never, ever too late. Welcome to Moms and Money, where we talk about making money, managing money, and saving money for the women in the household. Now, in today's video, we're going to be talking about four careers that you can have that you can make $100,000 a year with no degree required. So that's no bachelor's degree, no associate's degree. All you need is a high school diploma. And I am talking about careers in the United States. I am not sure that any of these careers will be as lucrative outside of the United States, but if you're here in the United States, these are four careers that you can have and you can make up $100,000 or more without a bachelor's degree or an associate's degree or any kind of university or college degree. There are a couple of things I want to talk about before we dive into what these careers are. First, you know, making $100,000 a year has really changed over the years. I looked up some data, and back in the 1980s, making $100,000 a year was a lot of money. And actually only 15% of the entire workforce made that much money. Because of inflation, $100,000 a year is not going to, you don't have the same amount of purchasing power as you did back in the 1980s. As a matter of fact, $100,000 a year in the 80s compared to 2020 is the equivalent of making $297,000 a year, okay, in 2020. And I know, depending on where you live, that may be a lot of money to you. It may not be a lot of money to you, but from $100,000 in the 1980s to $297,000 in the 2020s, that's a big jump. You know, of course that's a 40-year span, 40 years of inflation. And of course these last 2 years have been absolutely bonkers. The economy has been crazy. This also includes the mass exodus of people literally quitting their jobs. I talked about that in my previous video about side hustles where you can make money or make money online. I talked about how so many people are quitting their jobs. It's like a mass exodus of corporate America. And honestly, I hope it's a wake-up call for a lot of these companies to really take the time to cultivate a really good work culture, a really good work environment for people, to pay people more. There's no reason why, you know, CEOs of these Fortune 500 companies make hundreds of millions of dollars a year in salary, okay? Where your lowest paid employee, your base pay employee, maybe makes $12 an hour, okay? It's just such a huge drastic difference. And I hope and pray that corporate America uses this as a time to really try their hardest to, you know, give people benefits again, a reason to want to work, you know, and a more of a work-life balance. Pay these people more. It's just not fair, you know? So I understand why so many people, especially during COVID, this was like a mass wake-up call for so many people to quit their jobs. Now also, a lot of these jobs are trade jobs, you know, or jobs in the trade industry, really blue-collar workers. You know, for a long time, like for instance, my father is in his 70s, and he said in high school, back in his day, you used to be able to learn a trade in high school. You can come out of high school and learning all about becoming an electrician or a woodworker or a welder, all those really great trades that are really profitable now. And honestly, they took it out of schools because they wanted to push getting a higher education, going to college, getting that four-year degree. And that's what people did. And they really stopped looking at trade jobs because they felt like, you know, going to college, getting a higher education was the way to go to ensure that you were gonna have a higher salary. But in all honesty, that's just not the way it works. It works for some, but not for everyone. You know, the cost of college has gone up 500%. I think the last calculation I did was it went up 400% from 1990 up into now. College education has raised 400%. And it's definitely a business, you know? And so for people to accumulate hundreds of thousands of dollars of college debt and then not to have that payoff in a salary is really sad, because unfortunately, not every, just because you have a degree does not guarantee that you're going to make six figures a year. And to be honest, depending on where you live, making $100,000 a year could put you right above the poverty line. Like if you lived in New York City or San Francisco, where it's some of the most expensive places to live in the country, making $100,000 a year puts you right above the poverty line. And can you imagine having hundreds of thousands of dollars of debt on top of that? You know, it's really sad the way that this country is going. So I pray and I encourage you that if you know someone, if it's you, or there's a young person in your life, an old person in your life, a middle-aged person in your life that is unhappy with their job, you know, they feel like there's no end in sight and it's just a constant loop of just negativity with their workplace, or maybe they're not happy because they're not making enough money, or it's a toxic environment, I pray that you have the courage to do something about it, because it's never ever too late. Now, I'm not telling you that it's easy, but it's never too late, because if God blessed you to open your eyes to see another day, that's another opportunity for you to move closer to where you want to be. You deserve to live the life that you want to live, that God puts you on this planet to live. And I pray that the Holy Spirit really guides you through this process, because honestly, guys, this is an unprecedented time, okay? You have an opportunity here to change the trajectory of your life if you wanted to. You do not have to keep working at a place that you don't like, or just feel like you're undervalued, you're not getting paid enough, you don't have the benefits that you need. You don't have to do that. You can totally change your life. And that's why God put us all on this earth. We all have talents that we should really live into and do your job with pride, and just so that you could be example to other people that everybody is talented, and you have to love yourself enough to know that you deserve to be happy at work. You deserve to be excited. You deserve to not have the Monday blues or dread going into work on Mondays. Trust me, I have been there. I know. So I just encourage you to, you know, step out on faith, pray about it, and I pray that the Holy Spirit moves you and guides you into the right direction. So let's start talking about these careers, these trade jobs that make $100,000 a year. The first job, you only need a high school diploma. Now, all these jobs, you're gonna need a high school diploma for sure, okay? Or a GED, I think. So the first job is a power plant operator. And basically what they do is they operate, manage the machinery in power plants that give us our electricity. Now, this job, usually you could start out at about $50,000 a year, but you can make up and above $115,000 a year doing this. None of these jobs are easy, that they're not all gonna just fall into your lap, but you can get into it and maybe take a little bit of a lesser pay and then work your way up into making six figures. These jobs are definitely learn as you go, gain experience as you go. So to get into these positions, you have to have like a stable work history to show that you can keep a job, that you're reliable, that you show up, that you can learn on the job, that you have the ability to adapt in an environment that changes, and that you learn quickly. That's how you get into these positions. Okay, so a power plant operator up to $115,000 a year. The second job is an elevator technician, or someone who installs elevators or fixes elevators or anything like that. These people make up to $114,000 a year. And again, this changes depending on where you live in the country. Because like I said, some people, depending on where you live, $115,000 is an extraordinary amount of money. And some people, depending on where they live, that's right above the poverty line. So these elevator technicians can make up to $100,000. Now, starting out, usually they make about 45, but then they work their way up quickly. Again, this is something where you learn and gain more and more experience working on these things, and that's how you're able to earn more. Not just staying at a job for 20, 30 years, but you gain the experience that you need, and then you go find another job where you make more money. That's how you build your income, working at different companies and asking for more money as you gain more experience. The third position is an air traffic controller, okay? A person who's an air traffic controller can make up to $175,000 a year. Now, it's hard to become an air traffic controller if you live someplace that doesn't have like a major airport. Like for me, I live in the Atlanta area, and Atlanta has one of the busiest airports in the entire world. And so yes, you can become an air traffic controller, but maybe somewhere like, I don't know, Idaho, it may be hard for you to become an air traffic controller, maybe, but you can, but maybe you won't be paid as much because it's not as busy as an airport. But you can definitely become an air traffic controller without a college degree. Now you do have to take a test. I think it's a federal aviation test to get into becoming an air traffic controller. But girl, Google is your friend. You can definitely prep for that. And it takes like a couple of years, but you can definitely make up to $175,000 and you do not have to have a college degree. The last position is a Whole Foods store manager. They make up to $100,000 a year becoming a store manager. Now, it takes time to get up to that level of becoming a store manager, but hey, that's six figures, and that's without a college degree. Another manager that makes $100,000 a year are In-N-Out, the burger chain, a restaurant. Those managers of those restaurants make $100,000 a year too. So you think going in like, oh my gosh, I don't wanna, you know, be a cashier or stock the shelves. But if you have a plan for yourself to get there in a time frame, it can definitely happen where you make these six-figure jobs. Okay, don't be afraid at starting at the bottom, no matter what your age. You know, if you have a plan for yourself and you see the light at the end of that tunnel, or you can see and envision yourself making this amount of money, you can definitely make it happen. Okay, because a lot of these jobs and these careers, you have to start somewhere. You know, usually it is at the bottom and you work your way up. You know, it's so important for you to have a plan for your life, you guys. Don't just settle for mediocrity. Okay, God put us here to thrive, okay, to have dominion. The Bible says we have dominion over this earth. We deserve to flourish, okay, and our lives deserve to flourish, you know. And I just pray that God opens doors for you, that he puts it on your heart to have the courage to do it, because I know it's hard, you guys. And sometimes the enemy gets in your ear and whispers and tells you that you're not good enough, that you're not smart enough, that you're not beautiful enough, or whatever it is. But don't listen to that. God would never talk to you that way. You know, God made us perfectly in his eyes. So I encourage you to pray about it. You know, I'm a Christian. I speak from a Christian perspective, but pray about it. And I pray that doors open and that you have the courage to do something else, even if it's not on this list. Just do something else that makes you happy. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel out, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.